the president has already put out a list of people he'd like to nominate to the Supreme Court. You know, on that list are two senators, Tom Cotton, Josh Hawley as well. I mean, your understanding tonight is you've had a little more time to think about this now and to reach out to some of your sources of how this is going to shake out in the Senate. Obviously, the president's going to put a name forward, but what happens with it thereafter?
I expect that he will put someone up rather quickly. I think it's also important to note that this is going to be a fight in the Senate Judiciary Committee, and there is one very important member of the Senate Judiciary Committee, actually the most junior member, which is Senator Kamala Harris. And she was expected to be on the campaign trail, obviously, over the next few months. But if there is a fight in the Senate, not only will she be taken off the campaign trail, but she will be put front and center in this fight and have such a unique voice as not only a candidate, but as probably one of the toughest questioners on the Judiciary Committee. Her questions to Justice Kavanaugh while he was being confirmed were some of the most pointed, and some of the ones that he was, for lack of a better word, the most riled up about during some of the most contentious parts of the hearing. So I think that we can expect that McConnell will not necessarily put his people in positions that are not going to help them with their voters in their districts and their states back home, but he is going to try to push somebody through because the likelihood that they're keeping the Senate is waning by the day. I did see, I reached out to their office to see if I can confirm this, but Alaska Public Radio was reporting that earlier today, Senator Lisa Murkowski was asked if she would confirm somebody now. This is before Justice Ginsburg passed away, and she said that she wanted to wait to see who Americans chose as their next president. So if that is the case, she is going to be one of the more important votes during this process. And if that is the case, Mitch McConnell may have to wait until after November 3rd to put someone up, even if President Trump is reelected.
There were questions, Alex, during the Democratic primary about court packing, about the idea of adding a seat on the bench because and those questions really more front and center than they've ever been because of this very scenario, because Democrats were afraid that Ruth Bader Ginsburg would pass away, that the Republicans would replace her with a conservative justice, and that they would then be left with a potential Democratic presidency and a very conservative court. Joe Biden in the primaries was a firm no on court packing. Kamala Harris had said she was open to it. You know, Pete Buttigieg, who is still working with the Biden campaign and may very well have some kind of prominent role in a Biden administration, proposed this whole new idea for bringing justices to the bench in general. I wonder if this, if Republicans get a justice through, if that changes, you know, the stage, the pressure on Joe Biden, on his stance there.
You know, it very well could. I think what's interesting is you hear about court packing on the presidential level. We heard about it quite a lot in the primaries, as you just explained, but it is not something that is widely discussed on Capitol Hill. Members of Congress that I've talked with, specifically Democrats in this instance, have been reticent to say whether or not they are supportive of court packing because I think it is not an issue that they want to wade into unless they absolutely have to. But they are critical of the way that Mitch McConnell handled Merrick Garland. Years later, you can still sense the bitterness when you speak to any Democrat who was there. So I would say that if for some reason they are able to get another justice through to replace Justice Ginsburg, that this is something that Senate Democrats would be open to now, basically for, in their opinions, having been burned more than once. But it's not something that they speak about, you know, as freely, I think, as presidential candidates typically do. I think also just important to note, you know, the rest of the court is not all that young either. There's been a lot of talk about whether Justice Breyer was going to retire if a new Supreme Court, new president was inaugurated, whether if President Trump lost, Clarence Thomas was going to retire, Samuel Alito. These are people who are into their 80s and late 70s. And so it's something that has been considered far beyond Justice Ginsburg. So we could end up within the next couple of years with a very young court as opposed to the very elderly court that we are seeing right now.